Drive with confidence. From routine service to complete engine repairs, you can trust the pros at A1 Quick Oil to get you back on the road safely. Drop it off or sit and wait in customer-friendly comfort. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.
Well, this is it, the day for qualifying of the upcoming March election. Nobody knows that any better than Police Chief Frank Edwards from Independence. That's where he's headed. We're at House on the Rock, where his brother, the sheriff, hosted his monthly prayer breakfast. So you're now qualifying for another term. How many does that make?
Well, Ken, I was elected the first time in 2010. And so I would have run in 12, 16, 20, and so that's just be 23.
I remember that, and you had to be talked into running. And it was a pretty hard effort by the town to convince you, because if you're a municipality, you can only have a chief that lives in the town. So somewhere along the line, you really got to love the job. You're a former math professor. It's the last thing I would have expected.
Ken, it's probably the last thing I would have thought I was doing when I was teaching at Southeastern as well. But it was an opportunity. I was asked to do it. The town needed somebody, and as it turned out, I liked what I was doing.
And what is your day like typically? Because people think about Independence, and there's just not that much crime.
There's really not, Ken. I laugh and tell some of my fellow police chiefs that we'll go a day without a call, or the call we get will be to go chase some chickens off of somebody's porch or something simple like that. But of course, we do have our crime, and we can do a lot to prevent that. If we just could get the people to lock their cars up, because we don't have people breaking into cars, but if the car door's left unlocked, people will go into it sometimes. So we can do a lot to help ourselves.
What about shoplifting? You know, there are quite a few stores now in Independence.
Yeah, shoplifting is a problem. We get called. The stores can ban the people from the store so that they can't go back in. If they do, it would be a trespassing charge. But we don't have what you see in some of our adjacent cities, where people just go load up a buggy of stuff and just walk out the door with it. They know they're caught, but nobody's going to forcibly restrain them and recover the items they're stolen. But we don't have that, and I'm glad.
I've wondered over the years, how can you keep body and soul together from a funding standpoint? You know, the days of these little towns all having their police departments, they may be numbered.
Yeah, well, I've been fortunate. The council has really supported us, and I think you get good return for their money. We do have funding challenges, but we, just like the people out there do, have to make the most of what money we have.
How many officers do you have?
I've got eight officers, and we're proud to say that all but one right now are post-qualified. And when I took office, we had one that was post-qualified. And the one that's not starts school in January, so she will be, by the summer, she'll be qualified.
You know, I would ask you what you say your improvements or accomplishments were, but in a small town, isn't a race like this really a popularity contest? If you even have an opponent right now, we don't necessarily know that you will.
It probably is, Ken. You know, in a small town, you will personally know your opponent, and you'll know the people on both sides, and you'll be friends with everybody out there after the election, you know, regardless of what happens. And that's not the same as when you have a state or a federal election, where so you're right, it can be a popularity contest.
Well, your brother is, of course, the sheriff. Then your other brother is the governor. Then your sister-in-law is the judge. What an odd situation to be in. Do you ever feel as though you get blamed? Somebody might not like whatever your governor brother did.
Well, I don't hear too much of that, Ken. I just hope it's not the other way around. I hope they don't get blamed for things that I do.
And it's also strange that you'll be of this family now, the last brother left in office, if you're successful.
Well, yeah, I mean, somebody has to be last, and, you know, I've retired from the Army, so this is something that I can actually afford to do. You know, the pay for police officers generally is not good, and I couldn't do this if I hadn't retired from the Army.
Well, what do you say, though, is a reason if there's anybody unopinionated in Independence, for them to vote for you?
Well, because I've been there for since 2010. I think they know me. They know what we stand for, what we can do. I've got an open door policy. I try to help anybody that I can, as long if I can do it without hurting somebody else. And I think we have a good town, and I hope to continue to keep it that way.
You can't afford to be without your vehicle. Bobby and his team of professionals at A1 Quick Oil will get you back on the road fast and with the job done right. All technicians are 100% certified. Behind Napa off Highway 51 North, give Bobby a call.
Here at A1, we don't work on cars, we fix them.